911 operators of Reddit. What call will you simply never forget? Not me, but my sister is a dispatcher. One time she received a call from a man who said he just killed his sister and brother. She kept him on the phone for 5 or 6 minutes to make sure he didn't run before officers arrived. She got him to admit they had all been drinking and playing cards, then got into an argument when one of them accused the other of cheating. The other two went to bed, but this guy stayed up stewing. Apparently he couldn't let it go. He shot each of them in their beds while they slept, then called 911. I heard a partial recording of the call and she sounded calm as hell. She told me she was screaming on the inside the entire time. Older lady, I want to say maybe early 70, calls in with a sort of polite urgency in her voice, tells me she thinks she's having a stroke, tells me she has her grandchild at the house with her, asks me to call her daughter to come get the child. By the time she's done giving me the phone number, there's just a very slight slur in her speech. By the time Em's got there, probably no more than 5 minutes or so, I couldn't understand a thing she was saying. Fascinating, disturbing, and profoundly sad hearing someone stroke out on the phone as they're talking to you. This actually happened one few days ago. I'm an emergency room technician, but one of our unit secretaries is someone who transfers calls and does other important tasks that keeps the place afloat as an EMT in the next county over. I was waiting for a patient to return to their room, talking with her, when she looks down at her phone. She tells me she has the dispatch app or whatever for ambulances and fire trucks, and every fire hall in the county had just received a call about a possible decomposing body. Apparently the neighbor called about a terrible smell coming from the property. Hazmat was called and everything, expecting a dead human body. Once they broke into the house, they found that it wasn't a dead human, but 38 dogs in the house. 11 of the dogs were dead and in varying states of decomposition. The place is still pretty much under wraps, but 16 more dogs were found in the shed yesterday. The two people who owned the house have since been arrested and charged with 51 counts of animal cruelty. All of the animals left alive were taken to the Humane Society, where half of the county has just about donated food or blankets. The whole thing is pretty messed up. But I now for sure respect the hell out of the EMTs and paramedics that walk through our doors every day. They really never know what they're going to see when they walk into a place. A woman masturbating on the phone. The first time she called, she sounded normal at first. Asked for an officer that never worked here. General conversation about this officer while she progressively got more extreme with her moaning. I eventually and gracefully ended the conversation. It was a wild time. I still remember her name and voice. The second and third times she called, I asked if it was her and she hung up right away. Why are you like this, Ms. Roberts? What is your end game? For clarification, we traced the number down to a woman in Florida. We're located in Missouri and our agency is a tiny part of why I like this job. Hunting her down and bringing her to justice probably would have gotten her off. Wouldn't have been worth the hassle. Not 911, but tele-nursing. People called me plenty when it should have been 911. Grandma calls me about her 16-year-old, 40-week pregnant granddaughter. Grandma said, "Hey, my grandbaby is pregnant and she just went to pee and said the cord is hanging out. Is that normal?" Me: "No, not even a little bit." I'll go with a lighter one. I once had an elderly woman complain that gang members tagged her shed. She also said she didn't want a black deputy. This is the South. The black deputy arrived and found that it wasn't spray paint, but that her shed was so dirty that slugs had eaten paths in the filth that created patterns. I've been a 911 dispatcher for 11 years in a medium-sized center, population 180,000. We have more than our share of crazy calls, but there are only a few calls that have stuck with me. For me, the ones that I can't get rid of aren't even close to being the craziest or most brutal. 8 years ago, I took a 911 call from a man who came home to find his adult sister had been raped and beaten. The suspect had wrapped a telephone cord around her neck, then tried to push her through the window of the apartment. He was understandably very distraught. She was still alive and was able to talk to me. She had not been blindfolded and I was certain I could get a description of the person who had done this to her. She answered all of my other questions but absolutely refused to give me any info on the suspect. I later found out that the reason was self-preservation. The person who did it was the brother who called 911 for help. He was so believable, it really messed with my head. I also felt horrible that I had continued pressing her for info with the person who hurt her was right there and that I could have potentially put her in more danger without realizing. Student paramedic here. Had a call being general broadcasted over radio when I was chilling in base with my mentor. We were on a two-man car. Ambulance operator who was broadcasting said something along the lines of, female, reportedly unconscious, police on scene. Major trauma, poor CPR in progress, confirmed arrest by police on scene. My mentor looks at me. We are off in 30 minutes at the end of a night shift, but we'd go anyway. We're around the corner. Make it there in no time at all. There's police everywhere, at least 7 squad cars. I'm nervous as hell and so is my mentor. As we approach the house, a man emerges, handcuffed by police. He looks content enough and smiles at us as we walk by. Police shout for us to hurry. We run over with equipment to front door and are met with one of the worst scenes I've ever seen, and will always be there in my mind. There's a woman lying on the ground, with the left side of her head caved in. Blood absolutely all over the place and brain matter scattered around the floor too. Police are doing CPR. We stop them when we see the patient has signs of pooling and rigor mortis. I'm literally sweating and on the verge of tears. This is not how I wanted my shift to end. Then, we hear from behind us more police in the house and the sounds of children. 2 kids are escorted out of a bedroom behind us with their eyes covered. And one of them asks, what's going on, where's mommy? My heart melted. I've never been exactly traumatized by a job, but those kids being shielded from what just happened to their mother will stick with me forever. A young man, 23 years old, called and told me he was going to commit suicide. He was my first call of my shift that day, very early in the morning. He planned to set his car on fire with himself inside. He was upset and crying, but he apologized to me. He said he was sorry I picked up the phone and he was sorry for how this was going to affect me. He hung up on me and the second time I was speaking to him I could hear liquid splashing in the background. He ended hanging up again and I never got him back. He did end up setting the on fire and it was fully engulfed by the time anyone got there. I'll never forget his name or voice and I simply hope I showed him kindness and compassion in his last moments. Edit. I'm fine. I am lucky enough to have an amazing support system in my co-workers and I have an awesome spouse to keep me grounded. This call made me a better dispatcher. It's easy to become desensitized to the horrific things we hear and this young man renewed my passion for helping people. I have a few. I took a call from a man whose 1-year-old daughter fell in the pool while unattended. At the time of the call she was not breathing, unresponsive, and had no pulse. My partner dispatched out fire and EMS. While I was on the phone, got the child's mother to start CPR. Fortunately she was certified and didn't require very much instruction at all. Just had to tell her to count her compressions out loud so I could keep up. Before first responders arrived, the baby starts breathing again. I believe she sustained some brain injury but nothing life-threatening. Had to go take a walk around the block after that one. Please, 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 if you aren't CPR certified, get certified. It very well may have been the difference between that child living and dying. On a lighter note, I also had a guy call in claiming he was having a heart attack. None of the info I got from this guy indicated he was even remotely at risk for one. Mid-20 male, average weight, no history of heart problems or any other medical history for that matter. Turns out he had smoked some particularly strong pot about 30 minutes prior to calling. Absolutely nothing wrong with him other than he was stone stupid. We got a pretty good laugh out of that one. I also took a call from a kid who was about 10 years old who thought it would be funny to prank call 911. He started off by saying there was a fire. I could hear him giggling in the background. Followed that up with meowing at me over the phone. Managed to get a good location off the call and got his address. This one still bothers me because it's so fresh and our community is hurting from it as well. Took a call from a hysterical woman advising me of a rollover crash that happened near her house. She lives near the top of a blind hill that people like to jump, like catching that butterfly feeling in your stomach. Although you can get air in the right vehicle. She tells me that a girl is laying on the ground about 30 feet or so from the vehicle. When asked if the girl is alive, she says, oh yes. Honey, she's wiggling around on the ground. My daughter is a nurse. She's checking on her now. Awesome. We hardly ever are lucky enough to have a trained professional on scene before a med unit can get there. But then she tells me her daughter is starting CPR. To be honest, that didn't surprise me. My caller was getting hysterical again and we already had first responders on the way, so I started asking more questions about the scene. Her daughter breaks CPR to get on the phone with me, tells me she can do compressions only, that the girl's jaw is completely gone. A bit stunned, I tell her to continue compressions. But rather than getting put back on with the original caller, I hear the scared voice of a teenage girl. The driver, is my friend going to be okay? I can't find anything to say for a moment. Finally, after what seemed to be too long, I say they're doing CPR. Dear, and we have help on the way. Are you and the other passenger okay? We're fine. Just please tell me she's okay. The girl on the ground was confirmed D. A woman complaining of spiders in her vagina in college. I worked as an EMT in a major city. Not the craziest call I ever had, but one of the wackiest callouts we ever got was to respond to a woman complaining of spiders in her vagina. I'll never forget pulling up to this major intersection where, sure enough, there's this old lady lying on the sidewalk with her pants off and legs spread up in the air. Turns out it was this transient lady in her 70s who had been having some wild hallucinations. We still had to check for spiders. For me, the worst ones are always the calls you can relate to on a personal level. I took a call last month from a father who discovered his son with a bag over his head and a note next to his body. I've taken a ton of suicide calls, but this one was particularly difficult for me because the son was my age, and the way the father pleaded with his son was almost exactly the same way I've imagined my dad if I were to ever do the same. I've had the same "come on, buddy, don't do this to me" running in my head at least 3 times one day since. Also, not technically a call but my first shift on my own. I dispatched the deputy I did my ride along with to a domestic that he ended up being shot and killed at. Hearing his blood-gurgled shots fired scream on the radio won't be something I'll ever forget. Answer to the sounds of a couple of women absolutely screaming and wailing. I'm sure anyone that has done the job long enough knows the type of scream I mean, that blood-curdling scream of someone in genuine anguish. Knew something was up and got police and ambulance on the way. Trying to get them on the phone to get details, and a boy of no more than 5 years old comes on the phone and says my daddy is swinging from the roof and his eyes are open and staring. Thanks for listening, my little ice cream sandwiches. Subscribe to Radio TTS for more videos like this.